G'day folks, Ben from Snowy's here today with a Zempire bomber pad sleeping mat. They're a 7 centimeter thick mat with a nice peach top to it, nice soft feel and a die cut foam inside. They offer a really good balance between weight, pack size and also price to make you sleep comfortably in your campsite. When you buy the mats, this is how they come. This is the twin here, about 70 centimeters in length and roughly 20 centimeters in diameter, depending on how much you pack it up or how tight you roll it up. And the twin, also roughly 70 centimeters in length and about 25 to 30 centimeters in diameter. Now I've got the single one in front of me here. I'm gonna take the twin out of the bag and let that inflate while we talk about all the features. And I can show you the valve while I do that. So inside the bag, which is just a draw top bag here, you get a little repair kit with some glue and some fabric patches, and then you get the mat itself. Now these are secured with a Velcro strap. It runs around here. We can put them aside. They're not attached, so make sure you keep them with the bag. Roll this out, and then we can undo the valve on the end here. It's just a single valve on the end that features on both the single and the double. I'll show you the single shortly. We undo that, and inside is a little one-way valve. Now at the moment, this is in deflate mode, so that is going to allow air to come out of the mat, but not back in. If we push this and flick it around, or we can actually just leave it right open if we like, that's now allowing air inside the mat. If we flick it around even further, that's in the mode whereby if we were to lie on the mat while it was tight, we could air wouldn't come out, but we can adjust the pressure. But for now, I'm going to leave it completely open like that. And I'm going to fold this right out and leave it on the ground to inflate for a little while we talk about the features of the single mat here. Now, the single mat here has been left to inflate for a little while, so we can see that the foam's now at full inflation here. From new, these mats are going to take a little while to expand. The foam's got a memory of being compressed from the factory, so when you get it home, just undo this valve and just leave it sit like this for a while. You can use a pump if you've got a fitting that fits on there just to blow a bit of air in to speed it up, but it's quite normal for this foam to take a few hours, possibly even a few days, to sort of expand to its full potential. Once it has done, this is how it will look. Now, we'll just talk dimensions firstly. Now, both mats are about 200 centimeters in length, give or take a few centimeters, depending on which one you're looking at. The single here, 63 centimeters in width, and the double here, 132 centimeters in width. And they're both 7 centimeters in thickness here. The single here weighs about 2.3 kilos, the double about 4.6 kilos. Regarding the fabrics that these are made of, the top surface here is a 75 denier peached polyester. It's got kind of a soft feel to it. Same with the sides here, 75 denier side. They're kind of stretchy, the sides on this, to allow the air to sort of, or the foam to feel a little bit spongy while you're lying on it. And the top's not a peach top on that, it's a 75 denier polyester on the base there as well. And inside the mat is an open cell die cut foam. It's got kind of this wave sort of texture on the top here that probably isn't going to make much difference to the comfort of it when you're sleeping on it, but it does look kind of cool. Now I'm going to lie on this mat shortly and show you how I can adjust the pressure and sort of give you an idea of how comfortable it is. But I just want to show you before I do that, the mat underneath here, the double, which has now sat for probably 5 to 10 minutes just with this valve open. And it's probably, I'd say, at about 50% inflation here. So probably a good 2 to 3 hours of sitting would see this mat expand right out to its full potential. But right now I'm going to put this aside and I'm going to lie on the single mat for you. I'm just noticing as I'm holding this up on the angle, you can really see this wavy sort of effect there. Now you might see it better on the camera there, but it's not a really high wave, but it does look kind of cool and it gives a bit of a texture to the top. I should talk off on a couple of other little features. Firstly, R value. Zempire don't put out an R value on this mat here, but we estimate it to be around about 6. There's no science behind that. It's just a bit of an estimation looking at other mats in the range. And this top surface here and the bottom surface are actually bonded to the foam inside. The only part that's not bonded are these stretchy sort of side material to allow the air to sort of bellow out a little bit on the sides there. Now I'll lie on it. This is inflated to the point where we've just left this valve open here. So it's sucked in enough air for the foam to expand. We haven't put extra pressure in there. I'm gonna lie on it like that to show you, I guess, how comfortable it is and how much I sort of bottom out. I'll do this valve up. You can put extra air in there. You could use your own breath to pump air in the end. Not preferable because you put moisture into the mat that way, but if you can find a pump with a large attachment, you can pump extra air in there to make it nice and tight. But if I sit on this now, just sitting on there right now, I can feel myself drop through to the bottom. There's still a fair bit of foam between me and the ground, so it probably still insulate pretty well and it's certainly not uncomfortable. But if I lie down, obviously my weight's then distributed along the entire length of the mat. And lying on my back now, I'm not bottoming out. I'm not sitting through to the bottom there at all. If I lie on my side, my hips feel pretty comfortable. My hips don't feel like they're bottoming out, but my shoulder, I've got pretty broad shoulders, is certainly sort of touching the bottom there. So not a lot of depth in the mat. Obviously it's a 7 centimeter mat, so you can only expect so much sort of adjustment there, but it's still pretty comfortable. If I did find that this was too tight, too firm, or if I put extra air in it and find that it's too firm, I can adjust it while I'm lying on it. If I come around to the valve at the end here, if you can grab a pointy item, not sharp, you can just press the little yellow valve in there and that's gonna let air out. I haven't got anything sharp here at the moment, so I'm just gonna spin that around. You can just hear the air coming out and I can adjust that down just to my own sort of comfort. So I'd probably actually want more air in there now, but I can certainly feel the difference just with letting that little bit of air out with my shoulder now sort of dropping through to the bottom. So there is a bit of adjustment there, certainly not as much as you would get in say a 10 or a 15 centimeter mattress, but the benefit of a thinner mat like this is the actual pack size of it when it's going in your vehicle is far smaller than a lot of the bigger mats in the market, and they're also really well priced. So I think these bomber pads are a really good upgrade from the original bomber pads that Zempire had made going back a while now. They offer the square-sided sort of functionality without quite the thickness of their more or their upper end mats and at a much more affordable price. You can check all the details out on these online at snowys.com.au, where you'll find them at our lowest prices every day. If you've got any questions though, let us know down in the comments below. Subscribe to our channel for all of our latest and greatest information, or check out some other videos like this one down here.